metaphor of zetas. I think some of you have heard him talking about the fairy tale of incarnation of cranes. And so I believe there are many zetas living in that forest. like Karik Zeta, Rima Zeta, and hopefully v-adic Zeta. And
so my talk today is about the work of Mishiba. So this is after Yoshinori Mishiba.
V-adic periods of T-modes.
So, let me take some notations. So, K is a rational function field over the finite field Q, and let M be a T-motive over K. As defined in the first lecture this morning by Professor Chiu. So, so this is his Abelian T-motive. So this is a free K T-module of finite rank plus some map for Venus. Satisfying some conditions. I will explain in more detail. So, before talking about V-adic stuff, let me recall the usual periods. So, this is how I explained in the paper. Starting from a T-module, define its petty realization to be so. Now I assume that M is K, it's S, a big in L, a big L. And it is phi fixed bar. So phi is acting on N by definition, and it also acts on L by a kind of Frobenius inversion that the people play here. And anyway, so this sits in by definition. And also, N is also this
set. Oh, what is L? Sorry, I didn't. What is L?
L, yeah, yeah. L is a
certain field. Yeah, so you see in the first lecture that there is a, the algorithm which is going to be so this is plus beginning of 15. Although this is not detail. This is the beginning of 15. So we can choose pages, space. Also, n is over 10 kb, so let's choose our basis n. Then, these are for basis, so there is a matrix transformation.
Period is basically this. Periods of M is by definition the entries of the matrix I. But for some reasons, it is reasonable to specialize
that's
so the entries of the psi is in here, and we can specialize the variable t to theta. These are the periods of N. So this terminology seems a little bit different from the usual one, like periodic function. Generally, periods are something which connects two different structures in one object, like in C, there are two C module. So the difference of these two Z modules are 2 to pi at the usual period. So in the similar sense, these are the periods. Yeah. And one of the basic questions is that is the algebraic independence of these segments? Transcendence dB
of the field extension. So as we have explained in the first lecture, the theorem of Arithmetic. Is that transcendence I want to write it here.
So theorem of Papanicolaus. Is that transcendental degree or field generated over k by all these fields is equal to the dimension of the multiplicative group of n. So, or Tanakian Dao group. Okay. So it's the Tanakian Dao group of the Tanakian category generated by N. So this is an algebraic group defined over. This is an algebraic group defined over F Q. So let's consider the v-adic analog. So here V is a monic irreducible polynomial of DP. One can attach to M its v-adic realization, denoted V of M. So this is defined to be a set P completed with v-adic completion of this rational function here. With M and this is a fixed part of phi. So phi now is acting on this on case it by raising to the fifth part. So here again we have the same diagram. If we take a basis, all this space and this space, then there is a matrix psi, and if we have periods. We can't, or we haven't been able to specialize a variable t to theta. So it is a little bit different from the last one. By the way, so this is a finite measure vector space for FQTV. Then the problem in the v-adic case is that our transcendental degree is equal to the dimension of the only part of group. So here MV is via the completion of M. So what we remark is that in this v-adic case, we have to consider the transcendence over this field, and we still have T. And ideally, I think we should eliminate T. Specialize T to theta, but we haven't been able to do that. And one reason is that we don't have a v-adic ABB criterion. So one remark. No ABB. V-adic. So this criterion ensures that the algebraic recreation over this preserves after specializing. Before all going into the details, I'd like to explain some applications. hope to have this v-adic panel.
But in the v-adic days, the situation is not so good. In that case, you can prove the algebraic independence of formal parity law. I say formal because it has scalar variable t. This is something like L alpha n in L such that sigma is a problem is vector and alpha n is alpha is some value in sigma alpha plus L alpha something like this. And under certain conditions, if you have several values of alpha, then these L alpha alphas are not much very independent. But we have more information on the end of theta. One thing, this is because we cannot specialize the theta, and also even if we could specialize t to theta, these usual v-adic zeta values are in FQTV, and if we could specialize t, then values are the results are about the algebraic independence over this field. So as long as zeta values are in this field, we get nothing. So we have to consider more. Anyway, so let me state the theorem a little bit more precisely. So the theorem is actually stated for v-adic five modules, and not only for T modules. And, so K is as before the function, rational function field. And in fact, this can be any. So this special field is not important. This can be any regular extension of the binary FQ. Regular extension means that the algebraic closure of FQ in the field is FQ itself. And F is FQ TV, and E is
this is not a field, but the product of fields,
which are isomorphic to Lorentz power series.
So the index is in Z over D, and this is according to the composition. So if V was a polynomial, so we can decompose it into a product. So this. Then this real completion is decomposed into the product like this. And let sigma act on these fields. Sigma act on E and L. By Q's power 1 okay, so and sigma P is so this sigma is a kind of inverse of one in the first lecture. In fact, more generally, so called admissible this is the most basic and important. I don't go into the details here. Yeah. So
I don't know. Thank you.
in the classical case, Papa Nicholas considered the religious analytically trivial ones. And we also did the similar thing. And that we can. So here again, phi acts on M by definition and acts on L by sigma. Phi acts on sigma M star phi. And this means the fixed part. Then this is F vector space. And we have a natural map. L is F E N M to L is M. And it is easy to show that this is injective. And if this is surjective also, then we say M is L trivial. So this is always the case if, for example, it comes from a T model. And we let phi M E L be the category of L trigger phi modules over E. And for M in this category, quotients, tensor quotient, yours like that, and gamma m be the Hamiltonian cover group. Show that this category PM are associated. Maybe I should say this before this is on the PM. So this category is nice and is a neutral. So the functor V mapping M to Vn. This is a fiber functor. Anyway, what I wanted to say is that we can use the machinery of Tanaka theory. And n is trivial.
Then, as before, you can choose a basis. Basis B. And then there's a matrix. So R is the trunk. basically a basic strategy, same as the company cost that is.
So since the period ring is like this, first thing
to consider is this. And let's see the state. Then, since when these guys are major experiments, this is naturally a sub-scheme of GLR. But this is not a root scheme. It's not a natural root. But it's a loser.
Such a morphism corresponds to here, there's a natural thing, natural computer. So for any 500N containing this category, there is a realization factor Vn. And this is just a vector space which there is a Galois representation. But in fact, we can make this gamma act on this because
automatically by definition. So